about you when the wind blew cold and the round tables began. There is come to our king's court many a well-favored man. The queen looked over the castle wall, beheld both dale and down, and then she saw young porters come riding to the town. His footmen they did run before, his horsemen made behind. A mantle of the burning gold did keep him from the wind. Golden graced his horse before, and silver shod behind. The horse young Walter's break upon was fleeter than the wind. Out then spake a wily lord, unto the queen said he, "Oh, tell me who's the fairest face rides in the company? I've seen lord and I've seen laird, and knights of high degree, but a fairer face than young Porter's mine eyes did never see." Out then spake the jealous king, and an angry man was he. "Oh, if he had been twice as fair, you might have accepted me. You're neither laird nor lord," she says, "but the king that wears the crown. There is not a knight in fair Scotland but to thee must bow down. For all that she could do or say, appeased he would not be. But for the words which she had said, young Walters he must die. They have taken young Walters and put fetters to his feet. They have taken young Walters and thrown him in a dungeon deep. Oft I have ridden through Stirling town in the wavert and the white, but I never rode through Stirling town with fetters at my feet. I've ridden through Stirling town in the wind, but and the rain, but I never rode through Stirling town, never to return again. They have taken to the hiding hill his young son in his cradle, and they've taken to the hiding hill his horse, but and his saddle. They've taken to the hiding hill his lady fair to see. And for the words the queen had spoke, young Walters he did die.